Are you ready to participate in a Feldenkrais awareness through movement lesson? The title of the lesson is Differentiate Radius from the Thumb. Carpal Tunnel Syndrome. Let's begin. Sit on the chair, please. Extend left forearm in front. Attach the elbow somewhere on the ribs. Rotate the forearm so that the thumb is above the fingers and closer to the ceiling. Of course, the small finger is in the closest position to the floor. Let the fingers and the thumb open as natural. Open the palm of the hand without intention or any power to do so. Now, bend the wrist so that the fingers go down to the floor and then return it to the beginning position or more or less the in the horizontal. Leave the thumb alone for now. Do this many times. Let's call this the distal movement of the wrist. Pay attention to the fingers. How do the fingers come close to the floor? In other words, pay attention how much the wrist bends. This movement is called adduction of the wrist. Now make a fist with the thumb inside of the fingers. Do the same movement. Notice how little the fingers go down. The thumb is limiting the movement of the fingers and the wrist. Leave it alone and rest with the arm long by the side. Come back to the same position. Attach the left elbow on the ribs. Leave the hand open. Rotate the arm so that the thumb is closest to the ceiling. Now, bend the left elbow upward and return. Here is a constraint. Keep the fingers in horizontal all the way. That demands to bend the wrist to the same direction as we did a minute ago. So we are adducting the wrist again, but moving the forearm instead of the hand. This is the proximal movement of the wrist. A bone that is closer to the body moves now. Do this many times. Rest for now. Come back to the same position. Attach the left elbow on the ribs. Leave the hand open. Rotate the arm so that the thumb is closest to the ceiling. Place the finger of the right hand on the bottom of the thumb or on the upper side of the wrist. Any finger or fingers do. You may use only the index finger or together with the mid finger. Now, slide the fingers along the left forearm to the elbow and then, return to the wrist. Like this, stroke the forearm a few times. Try to feel the long bone there. The bone is called radius. Like any other bones in the body, this is not a straight bone. Feel the shape of the bone and enjoy it for a while. We are looking for the length of the radius bone. Now, feel the sticking bone closest to the wrist. This part of the bone is called the styloid process of the radius. Did you find it? Okay. Now place the fingers there and keep on attached. Slide the tip of the left thumb closer to the small finger and then, return to the index finger. Do this many times very gently. Pay attention to the bottom, or the neck of the thumb. The thumb needs to go away from the styloid process of the radius. And then they come back closer to each other. We are moving the thumb away from the radius now. However, you may feel the radius dragged by the thumb. To be exact in the information, there are few tiny bones in the wrist. When you pull the thumb away from the radius, these tiny bones are involved, too. Take the right fingers away. Rest a bit. Come back to the same position. Attach the left elbow on the ribs. Leave the hand open. Rotate the arm so that the thumb is closest to the ceiling. Now, as we did before as a proximal movement, bend the elbow and keep the thumb and the fingers more or less in horizontal. And return the forearm in the horizontal. Do this gently a few times. As the elbow bends, the forearm and the wrist are lifted. But the hand is kept in the horizontal. Pay attention to the wrist. Do the radius and the thumb go away and come closer from each other? Next time when the wrist is in the highest position, stay there. Make sure the hand and the thumb are in the horizontal position thus, the thumb and the radius are pulled away quietly. Now, slide the thumb on the hand closer to the small finger and then return it to the index finger. Do this many times with the utmost gentleness. Rest with the arm down by the side. Come back to the same position for the last time. Make a fist with the thumb inside of the fingers of the left hand. Bend the wrist as we did in the beginning and see the difference. Open the hand and do the same. Do you feel any differences from the beginning? Stand up and walk around and bend the wrist and the thumb as you walk. Actually, bend and extend the wrists of both hands. When do you bend and extend the wrists and the thumbs as you walk? Are there any relationships among thumbs, wrists, and the elbows? This concludes the lesson. Thank you.